Bobbies, thanks for tuning into the KG lifestyle. Yes, it's still KG. I got a protective style put in. As you can see, I'm loving it so far. These are woolly goddess locks, or they're kind of bushy and a little thicker than the normal ones. So if you want more information about that, let me know. It's also the information on who did my hair here in Dallas is on my Instagram page. So today is all about the tea, y'all. I am so excited to share some of my hard learned lessons when it comes to home ownership. I really have gone through a process. We'll just call it a process, but I'm so excited because I get to share my experience with you. Not only that, but I am closing on my home today, like the day that you're watching this video. So I'm super excited to do that. I'm trying to kind of chill out. I've done all the preparation work and stuff, so I'm excited to finally get this process done. I want to thank Community Coffee for sponsoring this video. So I've always known about Community Coffee because, I mean, they're a huge brand, right? But I never knew they made tea. Did you guys know they made tea? And no. And you guys know I'm a tea fanatic. So I was super excited to partner with them to bring you these tips and to also share with you guys a giveaway. So stay tuned for that in a couple of minutes. I'll outline a huge giveaway so that you can enter that. But let's get started on this tea, y'all. Like, I know y'all were like, wait, what do you mean you can't afford your home? So the first tip that I have is for you to set your expectations. If you have home ownership as a goal of yours, you need to set your expectations and make sure you're not, you know, really just getting a home because the lady who lives next to you did, or because your, you know, sister did, or because your line sister did. Like, nah. You have to decide why you want a house. Like, what is a home going to do for your financial situation? What is the reasoning? And so for me, that was definitely financially, I wanted to invest in real estate, right? So I was specific with my choices based off of my decision. The why determined the how. So you need to make that decision for yourself and make sure that you're looking at your financial situation. Don't say to yourself, well, I should be able to afford the home that X, Y, and Z person afforded. No, you might not, and that's okay. In addition to that, make sure you're not avoiding money when you're setting these expectations. You don't want to avoid your financial situation. If you know you got that bill that's, you know, past due or whatever, I mean, you really got to take care of that. When you're setting your expectations, you're not looking at mansions online, right? So I know a lot of people who just surf Zillow all the time, and they're always looking at these homes that are like millions of dollars, and they're like, wow, look at this home. I think it's great to dream. I do that occasionally, but when it came to my home search, I knew exactly what I was gonna be able to afford and what I felt like I needed or wanted. So definitely set your expectations. The second tip that I'd like to give, determine your lane based on who you are. So a lot of people gave me a lot of feedback. I'm talking about a lot of feedback, and some of my most treasured family members and friends wanted the best for me, but I know who I am. So I decided to do new construction because I know the person I am. So it's not that I didn't try as a first time home buyer. I didn't try out the route to do, to own a pre-built home, or I didn't try out the route to look at situations where I might be able to do a, remodel situation. But after I looked at the situation and honestly said to myself, is this something I could do? I could not say yes. And so if you can't say yes to those other lanes, stay in your lane. You know, just stay right over here like, okay, this is what I'm gonna get. One thing for me is I'm not a settler. So I'm not gonna settle for something just because it may be a good idea for that person, or just because if I settle or if I go with a pre-built, I could get a house this year. No, I decided what I wanted based on who I was. I wanted to be able to pick out some of the things in my home. I wanted to be able to plan, you know, the savings time out, because when you're doing a new construction, you can kind of plan that out and pick which location. I'm extremely particular when it comes to where the sun rises and sets. Y'all, like, I'm extremely detailed. So for me, me only, this was the best situation for me. That doesn't mean your lane, you know, is not going to be a bumpy lane. You know, when you stay in your lane, it may not be, you know, exactly what you thought it was going to be, but at least you're in your lane. That's the start. Number three, don't apply for anything before you found exactly what you want and you've prepared. So don't apply for anything until you found exactly what you want and you've prepared. So for me, in my situation, I knew after I, you know, went down that road of elimination and decided, okay, I'm not going to do a pre-built, I'm not going to do a remodel. And I said, if I'm going to do new construction, I need to find where I want this home, right? And so I picked all of the new construction sites that were in the Dallas, Fort Worth area, and then narrowed that search down to what exactly I wanted, like what exactly I wanted, what floor plan, et cetera, et cetera. So that was the process for me. When I found that home, that's when I said, okay, let's see what this financial situation looks like when it comes to the application. Of course, I already had prepared. Y'all, this process has taken me probably 5 years of cleaning up my credit. I mean, 5 years of cleaning up my credit, getting rid of bad spending habits, right? Saying to myself, okay, if I really want this, I need to start saving and putting myself in a position where I'd be able to put down a down payment and a large one if possible. So I contacted the bank and looked at the rates and things like that just to ask questions. I mean, I've had several conversations with the loan officer before I even gave him any of my personal information to run my credit. What are the requirements, or what is your approval process? What does that look like? What are your rules for accepting people? What is your debt to income ratio? I even asked what they can do versus what others could do, because I knew I had prepared and gotten my credit score over 800. So I said to myself, if I did all this work, I need to make sure I'm getting the best rate in the best financial situation. So that's what I did. I made sure I asked those questions, and not only asked them, but backed them up with my research online. So very important. Don't apply for anything until you know what exactly you want and you've prepared. You've got your down payment for the most part, or at least have a plan to save for that down payment. If you're doing new construction and, you know, your credit is clean and you're in a financially stable situation. Okay, number four is patience is a virtue. Y'all, I had to learn this lesson. All these things are lessons, really. But this lesson was really hard for me because I did not want, everything is on a schedule for me. And when you deal with new construction, the schedule changes from day to day and you may not be able to do all that you want to do when you want to do it. So I really, 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 really had to learn this lesson the hard way. Approach this differently than any other large purchase you've ever made. I've owned two cars and I thought that was something. And even in those financial situations, I made sure I was pre-qualified before I even went shopping for a car. But in this case, this is way bigger, okay? So you gotta really prepare your mind and your heart to be patient through the process. Again, especially if you're doing new construction. Another extremely important thing that I learned was if I feel pressure, so if the bank was pressuring me to do something, I ran away. Like, I was like, oh no, you're not gonna pressure me into a financial situation for the next 30 years. Granted, I probably won't be in the home for 30 years, but if you feel pressure, that's not the right thing, especially if you know that you're supposed to feel peace with your decision, right? Doesn't mean everything's gonna go as planned, but you should at least feel peace about the situation. Another thing is, if your lease is up and, you know, this loan process is taking longer because you're negotiating, don't settle on your negotiation because your lease is about to be up. You have to have patience with yourself and you have to have patience with the process. And so if you know that something is really important to you and that bank isn't going to give it to you, walk away and find another bank. That just happened to me this week. I almost had to go to another bank because the loan that I was getting was, you know, a little bit jacked up. Before they fixed it, you know, they were saying, well, if you want, you can close, or you'd have to go and pay for another appraisal and do this and this. And I said, that's fine. I'm not going to settle for what you're trying to offer me just because you're pressuring me into this time. Number five is pretend. So pretending is an interesting thing because I wasn't able to do this throughout the life of my waiting period, I guess you could say. I purchased a location that was far out. So like they have different, let's just call them phases. So they have different phases and I chose the last phase. So I did that on purpose because I know I needed an amount of time to save and I'm extremely goal oriented. So I went under contract. That's my goal, to get this home. Then I had to go ahead and figure out, okay, what am I going to do with these few months to really prepare myself for home ownership, the financial burden of home ownership, a mortgage. I attempted to basically pay my mortgage to myself. The proposed amount of your mortgage, subtract your rent, and then save that additional, whatever that is, that's what you have to save. So you're pretending like you are already in the home. That's a really great way to see if your lifestyle is going to be able to work with the kind of life that you're trying to have with this new home. And you're saving, so it's like perfect because you're able to save the money that you're going to put down anyway, and you're kind of gearing yourself up and developing those good habits when it comes to home ownership and savings, financial savings. So I hope these tips really helped you guys. This was just a little bit about the whole, you know, preparation stage of everything. So to clear this all up, I can't afford the home that I purchased a year ago because the property value has shot up. So, you know, on Zillow, where you go on and you search homes within your budget or a little bit over, just because you may have some negotiating skills and you want to see like what's out there. Yeah, I can't. No, this wouldn't even, my house would not even show up on that list. So that's amazing. Thank you, God. Extremely blessed. Can't believe it. But again, investment. I was very, very adamant about buying in an area that was going to increase in property value. Why not buy in a place that is going to increase value, but also work with the other things on my list? So that is the reason why. I'm really excited to get into the home to show you all and to make sure that I give you even more tips when it comes to this home ownership thing. Again, I want to thank Community Coffee. Let's go ahead and get into this giveaway. So I want to see your favorite mug. Again, this is my favorite for the moment. So in order to win, I need you to enter this giveaway on Twitter, Facebook, or Instagram. I need you to enter on one of those avenues. If you ain't got one of those, I don't know what to tell you. Just snap a picture of your favorite mug and show me on Twitter, Instagram, or Facebook. Hashtag it, show your mug, and I will check those out. I can't wait to see what other mugs you guys have because I might have to copy some of you. Now, this is an amazing thing because this is your chance to win a year supply of Community Coffee and other coffee goodies just because you're sharing your favorite mug. Okay. I'm so excited about this giveaway. Thank you again to Community Coffee for sponsoring it. Can't wait to see your mugs. Don't forget to thumbs up and subscribe to the notifications, and I will see you later. Peace and blessings. Bye.